Okay, so we are back, and in the previous video, we finished setting up our punching animation montage, allowing our character to run around and punch in our level here. So if we play in the editor again, I can punch once, I can hold down the left mouse button, punch multiple times, but I can also run around and punch, or jump and punch. So our character is somewhat playable now. The last thing that I wanted to do is allow our character to kind of interact with our world a little bit. So let's go ahead and do that. I'm going to hit escape to exit my play session here. Down inside the content browser, what we're going to do is go to the character folder. We're going to go to our character blueprint here and double click and open it up. And inside of our character blueprint, let's hop over to our viewport. So we're going to go to the viewport tab up here so that we can see our character. And what we need to do is add some collision somewhere around his hand so that when his hands punch outside of our collision capsule here, which is used for our general collision to make sure that our character can't pass through things. But when his arms extend out past our capsule collision, we want to add collision around his hands so that he can interact with the world. So we're going to do that kind of in a cheap way here, but should get the job done. So to do that, let's go up to the components window and let's click add component. Let's search for a sphere component. And there's two options here. We want to use the sphere collision. So go ahead and select that. And let's call this the right hand collision. Like so. And let's add another one. Let's add another component, sphere. Let's just add another sphere collision. And we'll call this one left hand collision. Like so. Now for both of these, let's select both of these. You hold shift and select both of these. Over in the details panel on the right, under collision, there's a collision presets section, which allows you to set the collision presets and how collision is used for these objects. Currently they're set to overlap all dynamic, which doesn't really hurt anything, but we're going to actually change this to no collision. Because we're going to turn collision on for these when the character is punching and only when the character is punching. So with that, I think we're good in terms of setting up their properties. Let's go over to our right hand collision now. Let's actually move that into position on his right hand. So we're going to move that over just a little bit, like so. Let's actually, one more thing. Let's go up to the top up here and our position grid snap value. Let's change this. Let's change this down to 1 so that we can move it more freely. Now, this doesn't have to be precise where we place this because we're actually going to attach this to the character's hand when they're punching. So I'm just kind of putting it close to his hand just for clarity on where it should be. So somewhere like this. And then also I'm going to hit R and go into scale mode and grab this white box in the center here and just drag it to the right to kind of scale it down a little bit, something like that. Let's hit W and move it back towards his hand a little bit better and down, something like that. That looks good. So we're gonna do the same thing for the other side. I'm gonna grab my left hand collision. I'm gonna move it over to my left hand. I'm gonna scale it down by hitting R and grabbing my white box here and dragging it to the right. You could also do this with the sphere radius if you wanted to change the size of the sphere as well. But I think this will do just fine. Hit W to go to translation and move it up towards his hand. Something like this. Something like that. He's idling, so he's moving in and out of it. But again, we're going to attach these. So I think that is good. This one's a little bit smaller than that one, but I think that's good. Let's compile and save. And what we need to do now is hop to our construction script. Now, we haven't used the construction script yet, but essentially what the construction script does is that anytime that this blueprint is constructed, as the name suggests, it's going to fire whatever is connected to this wire. Now, when we say constructed, that means inside the play session or inside the editor. So anytime any changes are made to this blueprint, inside the level editor, the construction script here will fire as well. So just a quick kind of briefer on what the construction script does. So what we need to do is grab our two collision spheres here. We can do that by going to the My Blueprint window under Components, there are our two collision spheres. So let's hold control and drag in our left collisions sphere component. Hold control and drag in our right hand collision. And what we need to do is attach these now. So to do this, let's drag off of our left hand collision and say attach to. Gives us two options, attach actor to component. We want the actual attach to. So let's go ahead and select attach to. And let's move this one down just a little bit. And it's going to say, what is the parent? What is the thing that we are attaching to? We're actually going to attach this to our mesh. So to get that, we need to go back to our My Blueprint panel. And it's not shown by default, but what we can do is go up to the view options here. Click this option. And we can show inherited variables. So go ahead and select that. And when you do, everything that is inherited is also shown in here. So underneath character, there is our mesh. So we can hold control and drag that in. Actually, I don't know if you need to hold control. Let me just check that really quickly for my own personal. Yeah, I guess you do. Still gonna give us a getter. Hold control and drag it in, and then connect that as the parent. So the in parent. And it's asking for a socket name. Now we can use a bone name as well. We're not gonna be able to see that inside the viewport here, but really quickly, if you need to know the bone name that you wanna attach it to, we can do that by going to, let's open our animation blueprint, for example, and go to the skeleton tab or any tab that has the skeleton in it. We can see the name of our hand. So it's hand underscore R where we're gonna attach it. And where's our other hand? Somewhere around here. Hand underscore L for our left hand. So those are the two names that we need to use. So inside our character blueprint again, the socket name that we want to use for our left hand is hand underscore L. And the attach type, the method that we want to use to attach it, we're going to snap to the target. So it'll snap the collision sphere directly to that location. So go ahead and snap to target. Keep world scale. We want to keep our scale. We don't want to change it because we've already set it. And then everything else is good. I think we're done. We can connect our construction script now to our attach to. And then let's copy this node. Let's control C and control V and connect these together like so. And let's grab our mesh here and connect that as the in parent. And let's grab our right-hand collision now and connect that as the target. Now we do need to change our socket name, so we're going to change this to hand underscore R. So let's change that to hand underscore R. And let's compile. You can see it fires and has been updated. Last thing that we need to do for our character blueprint here is to turn on our collision when we are punching. This should be pretty easy. We can hop over to our event graph to do that. So let's go to the event graph, find our punching script here, and let's go and get our left-hand collision. So we're going to hold control and drag that in, and hold control and drag in our right-hand collision. And what we want to do is drag off of the left-hand collision and say set, or is it enable collision? Set collision enabled. That's the one that we want. So go ahead and select that, the set collision enabled. And once that's selected, connect the set here off the is punching to our set collision enabled, like so. And we can connect our right-hand collision as well. Let's connect that to the target, like so. And the type of collision that we want to apply, we don't want to apply no collision. We actually want to enable collision. So for the dropdown, change that to collision enabled. So whenever we are punching, set collision enabled for our two collision spheres here. The last bit of business that we need to do, let's hold, select our node, hit control C to copy it and control V to paste it. And let's connect our punching false. And set our collision type to no collision, like so. And then let's connect our left hand to the target and our right hand to the target as well. So let me select these two nodes and just move them up here for a little bit of clarity, like so. And expand our comment section. There we go. So we are done. We are done setting up our punching. Let's compile and save up here at the top. So compile and save. The last thing that we're going to do, let's hop back to our level here. Let's add something in here that we can actually interact with. So I'm going to use starter content for this. Going to go down to the starter content folder. And under props, let's not go to props. Let's go to shapes. So the shapes folder here, let's just grab our shape sphere and drag that into our level like that. Where's our character? There he is. Let's make it a little bit bigger. I'm going to hit R and then grab our white box in the middle here and drag it to the left, kind of scale it up. And then over in the details panel, we need to find the physics section. And we want to set this to simulate physics. So go ahead and turn that on. And with that, we should be able to go over to it and punch it now. So let's test this and see. So we'll play in the editor here. Now, whenever we punch, our collision should be enabled, and we should be able to punch our little sphere way off of our level like so. That was beautiful. So that's it. We are done. Our character can now punch things. Had these things been physics objects, we could probably punch them too. We're going to wrap here. In the next video, we're going to set up our particle effect so that when we're running, we can kick up some dust to kind of use our animation notifies in a particle effect. So we'll wrap here, and in the next video, we'll set up that particle effect for when we are running. Thank you guys for tuning in, and we'll see you in the next video.